Hi.
Hi there. I'm Jeremy, showing off our Ventana product. This is true micro-LED, extremely high dynamic range. You can build any shape and size wall you want to create something over 200 inches, or go small, or go different shapes and sizes.
Is it over 200 diagonal?
This is over 200 diagonal. This is about 220 inches. We're actually feeding this on the HDMI booth with an 8K video signal on a physical 6K size screen. So the processing that lives inside these tiles can actually upscale and downscale. And I'd like to show you the form factor of this as well.
This is so cool. There's a bunch of tiles in there.
Exactly.
Right? If we can have a look right here against the wall, you're showing them. So what do you see here?
So the large display is made up of many modules of micro-LED, and these are put together in a very interesting form factor. So we have a square tile that's about a square foot, 300 by 300 millimeters. It's extremely thin, and it goes up on a very simple magnetic grid. So we put a grid on the wall for the tile array. There are no cables, very simple magnetic connections, and it's very easy, even as like almost a DIY TV, to take these on and off the wall and build up any shape and size you like.
So a bunch of magnets here and some pogo pins, or what
Correct.
Do you call those?
Yes,
and
exactly.
And then they all connect magically.
They magically connect. We make an auto mesh between all the tiles. They're very simple to put on. Just clicks,
Whoa.
That's it.
I could do it.
You can do it yourself. And then the tiles energize, they talk to each other, they know who's to the left, who's to the right, top and bottom.
You can mix them.
And you can mix any shape and size you want.
That's awesome. Nobody does that.
Nobody. This is the only display product like this on the planet.
How do you make sure nobody pulls them off and takes them home?
That's a good question. For a commercial application, we do have a little safety on the back so that you can do exactly that. So we have a mechanism here that can actually screw in so that the tile can't be removed, like with a safety wire.
Then you need access behind, right?
You could do a safety wire, like if you're old enough to remember going to the bank and having to write the deposit slip with the pen, and it has a little chain on it, we can do a safety wire. So you might be able to pull the tile, but it would not come off the wall. But also when you build a large array, there's no way to physically actually grab the edge of the tile like we have on this demo. And so you would need special maintenance tools to take the tile off.
All right. So there it's obvious there's a delimitation because it's two different videos. And I guess, does it have to do with calibration to get rid of any visual, what do you call it, borders? Or how does that work?
Yeah, so we have an array of the tiles, and so every individual module there's six in every single tile, each module gets individually calibrated for every red, every green, every blue of every single pixel. This metadata is actually stored in memory in the tile, so when they're all connected, they automatically calibrate themselves to know where they are in the array and what colorimetry they're supposed to have. And we're showing here, these will look visually different because we're showing both finish options that we have. So some applications, people prefer a matte finish. Some applications, people prefer a glossy finish. So the glossy we call liquid black. This has the deepest black level, very similar to an OLED TV. And this is fantastic for the best high dynamic range. Wonderful for any kind of environment where you need that very deep inky black.
So I'm just standing here in front of this trailer, right?
Yes.
And this is glossy, I can see, right?
Yes, this is glossy. We felt for a trade show we wanted to stand out a little bit more. So this is something very large with the glossy that it does have some glare because of all of the trade show lighting, but it looks more like an OLED TV than looking like something technical that might be in a conference room. And so we thought this was a very innovative surface finish.
When it's glossy, there's also the risk you might see the separations a little bit more than when it's matte?
Yes, correct.
So when it's matte, you don't see anything?
When it's matte, you don't see those at all. So that's a trade-off that you have to make when you make the choice between the surface finishes.
So when I go here to the matte, I need to be very, very close to see anything, right? At any kind of like distance, it'll be impossible to see. Right? Because I'm talking about those huge lights that
exactly.
are up in the roof. And CES always has these huge lights.
Yes, exactly.
And you're fighting with that a little bit.
Exactly. We fight with that a little bit on the trade show floor, but typically in a living room, you wouldn't have those types of lights, so we don't have the same type of glare on the edges.
And you say 8K, you mentioned 8K.
Yes, we can ingest 8K. We can also actually run rasters that are 16K and 32K even. The background of our company, Ventana is the brand name of these micro LED tiles. Our company is called Megapixel, and many of us have been in even the filmmaking industry for 20 years. And so a lot of the tile technology, as well as the processing technology that's built into this, is actually used for motion picture production. And so we're bringing cinematic technology into the home, and you're getting basically the best possible picture quality that you can in the world.
What do you think people would want to have, glossy or matte at home?
You know,
if somebody has a big enough wall for this, what are they going to choose?
I feel sometimes like that's asking somebody if they'd prefer a Ferrari or a Lamborghini. Everybody has personal choice when it comes to things. I personally would do the liquid black because I love the very, very deep black level. I think it has a surface finish that's unlike anything else. But let's say you're putting something in your home where you're not watching movies. Maybe you want to display artwork down a hallway and you want a square display or a portrait display. For artwork, absolutely you would want the matte version because that would be more reflective in feeling for the light.
If it's a home cinema, you're probably not going to have CES lights in your living room.
Exactly. Home cinema, the inky black amazing HDR that you get with the liquid black is the way to go.
Nice. This is awesome. So this is a thanks. Great tool for architects.
It is, absolutely. Thanks for pointing that out. So one of the things that we did when we designed the system is we wanted the shape and the tile to actually mimic a building material. So the reason that we chose a square tile and that we made it exactly the thinness that it is because we wanted an architect or an interior decorator to pick it up and think about it as a building material.
Could you pick it up and just show
yes,
it right here?
Yes, let me grab one for you. So the shape and size of the tile is very very much the same that you would have for a marble tile or a ceramic tile. Same thing with the thickness. So this can actually be treated as a building material, and an architect can design this into a space. This can be everything from a 30-foot long kitchen backsplash to an entire wall. You could do a ceiling. You could wrap around columns. You could wrap around a fireplace. Really anything where you can put wallpaper and paint and drywall and stone, you could do a media tile as well.
So one thing I'm afraid to ask, right? But the eventual dream is that these are not too expensive.
Correct. So in today's market with this technology, it is indeed still expensive.
Displays, it's brand
new. Exactly. It's brand new, never been done before.
You need mass production to get the price down.
Exactly. So screens that are fairly large, they'll start in the low six figures and can go even up to $1 million. This particular tile, though, we absolutely will see over time will come down in cost. And this is something that, eventually, maybe you'll buy at a tile section of Home Depot or at a Best Buy shop and walk out with 10 tiles.
At the Costco.
Exactly.
You just go to the aisle 11, the shelf, and you just get your thing, and you put it directly in your Cybertruck trunk or something, and then you just
exactly
bring it home.
Right.
And in terms of square meter or square feet, what would be great is eventually, you cannot match the LCDs maybe, but an OLED or something like that. If you can get that kind of price as a home OLED 65-inch in terms of price per square feet.
That's exactly right, and it absolutely will go there. So in today's market for a television application, this is definitely aimed at anything much larger than 100 inches because a TV cannot be produced much larger than that. But absolutely, eventually you'll be able to just build any shape and size TV that you want. And you're not limited by making it 16:9 either.
How many are there of these there?
This is 16 tiles wide by 8 tiles tall, giving us a diagonal of roughly 215 inches.
And that's, you say 8 times 16? Oh, what do you
correct.
Say? 8 times
correct.
16, so that's...
So if my math is right, is that 144?
126?
126.
What is it?
128, there we go.
128, yeah.
Third time's the charm.
So there's 128 of these for between six figure and a million, so people can calculate.
Yes.
Basically, right?
Yeah, and, yeah, this would be sort of somewhere in the middle.
All right. And do you get 4K with that many, or you need even more to do 8K?
You go,
to do 8K, I mean.
It's actually even bigger. This size screen is about 6K resolution native. So we're able to either bring in 4K content and scale it up, or 8K content and scale it down.
And so to do the full 8K, you need a few more of these.
Yes.
Right.
Yes, you'd go a little bit bigger.
And where is the processing happening? Do you have a huge supercomputer behind it with the
NVIDIA GPU
and everything?
It's very simple. So you can be playing back content off of a computer, something like an Apple TV, Blu-ray, PlayStation, all these kinds of things. So any kind of normal source. We're here in the HDMI booth, so certainly anything with an HDMI output you can plug in, and it's just plug and play. And then that goes into a processing unit that I can show you in this credenza here. It's one RU, and that one RU can process 35 million pixels in any shape and size, so a couple hundred of these tiles easily.
All right, let's ask just behind here if you can...
Do you mind if I access this?
Do you want to see under here? There's like the processor that runs the whole screen.
All right. Let me move some things down here.
Right. So that's the render.
So this is the processor. Let me peel this off here.
Yeah.
So our company Megapixel manufactures this. This goes into digital cinema. This goes into screening rooms. This makes blockbuster movies. We're driving a lot of virtual production, a lot of broadcast studios, other booths even here at CES that have third-party LED. We drive with this. So we've been in the professional display industry for many, many years, and Ventana is the first tile that we're launching as a consumer product.
So people know Megapixel out there?
Absolutely.
Yeah.
And you can even go buy an LG micro-LED or Sony micro-LED that will come with the Megapixel processing system.
Oh, wow. So micro LEDs that are coming, you're there.
Yes.
This is
we're at the center of all of it.
0.8?
This is 0.8.
Dot
we
pinch,
also,
right?
Correct. We also have a 1.2 millimeter launching later this year for larger arrays.
And how about going even smaller? Does that make sense?
It does make sense. One
so
of the things
you could fit 8K in there.
You could fit 8K in there. So one of the things that we've focused on is that we like the 0.8 because it's a good ratio of being very high resolution but having good black level and allowing somebody to go very big. When we go smaller dot pitch, it is more challenging to have an amazing black level like we have with the 0.8. And then the cost goes even higher because the cost per pixel really is what you're paying for. So this seemed like a good sweet spot for us to start with.
Do you work with partners to the technology might be used if mass transfer, or how does it work to actually manufacture these?
That's a good question. We don't talk about that publicly, but what I can say is that everything is manufactured under our own designs, our own controls, and factories that we have staff at. Everything is made in a full stack where we own the hardware design, the firmware, the software, all of the programming and the processing. So it's a little bit akin to like an iPhone, where one company that's able to design every single aspect of hardware and software can kind of make 1 + 1 = 3. And that's what we've done with this product.
And where is that? Do you make it?
We make all of the processing actually in California, and the tile is produced in Taiwan.
All right. So that means, I don't want to ask the secrets or anything, but it could be like an ASIC or FPGA or something that kind of...
Yes, exactly.
Yeah.
So we have a large SoC that's in the main processor. That's handling all of the 8K and all of the distribution, whether it's baseband input from HDMI. We go output fiber optic to the tile array. And then every tile actually has a very small processor built into it. So every time you add a tile, you're also adding a video processor. So the larger your wall, the larger your processing array, actually. And everything works in harmony and stays in sync.
And my website is also armdevices.net. So I'm guessing it might be some ARM SoCs in there. Could be.
There might be some ARM processing happening, yeah.
And especially the smaller one and all these tiles, mm-hmm. could make sense.
Yep.
And then you just need to drive however many pixels there is in one.
Exactly.
And how many are there in one?
So in the 0.8, this is 360 by 360 pixels.
All right. And so the one that's here, is it fully calibrated already? Like you said, it's like pre-calibrated and everything?
Yes, this wall here, we've taken to quite a few trade shows already. So this is definitely not a product that's meant for rental usage and going in and out, but it has been used several times. But this all gets calibrated on site. We typically take 2 days for an installation, 1 day to prep the wall and make sure that it's flat and that we have power run and everything. Then a second day is for the tiles to click on and get calibrated.
Because if I understand correctly, the calibration is about making sure the whole colors and the brightness is smooth throughout.
Yes, that's exactly right. That's exactly right.
So you don't see any...
We don't want to see individual modules. We don't want to see individual tiles. So when this gets installed in a home, it's absolutely like a sheet of paper.
And I guess some people with huge mansions are interested. And otherwise, it's mostly industrial, right? It's mostly
it's
retail.
Both. It's both. So as a company, we provide displays for high-end luxury brands. In retail, we do some things in automotive, we do things with factories as well, concert touring, movie making, but we have these now going into the home. It's now in a form factor that's not a bulky industrial thing, and it's something that's a nice form factor that can go into a home.
And if you don't mind, if I can just ask a little bit, the first time I come back since 2020, and this sphere is pretty cool.
It is.
How did they make that? What is it? It's big pixels.
Yeah, so on the outside of the sphere, that's actually very large illuminated pucks that are kind of acting as a video pixel. So that gets all mapped and it's driven by GPUs. And then the interior is also LED, made out of many shapes and sizes of modules that go together. Very industrial. Mechanics behind it to hold those together, but it's also LED technology, just not quite the resolution and sophistication of this.
What's awesome is that Las Vegas is the number one convention mm-hmm. city in the world. Everybody gets to see that, and it just gets the hype up for all the applications.
That's a good point. It's really nice.
Everybody wants that stuff now.
Exactly.
Right?
It raises the awareness of LED in general. And the type of technology that it is. And it's quite differentiated from LCD and OLED. And it really, we believe, is the future for all of the high-tech displays.
It's a bit hard to make a big LCD like that.
It is, yeah. You wouldn't be able to get that up the elevator of your condo building.
You need a Gen 45 fab or something.
Yeah, that's exactly right. And a helicopter to drop it onto your roof.
The OLEDs will have a size.
The OLEDs won't get that big. And now if you want something that big, you can just have a box of tiles. And so... these can be carried in very simply and easily.
And the argument here at the HDMI booth is you want 8K, okay, but you need a big to actually see all the pixels.
Yeah.
You need a bigger.
Exactly. You need a bigger display. And so how do you have a bigger display? This is a perfect solution.